Now you are listening to Alex Belfield at breakfast. Oh, you naughty boy, Alex. Oh, Alex, it is so wonderful being in the broom cupboard with you.
Oh, Alex.
Well, the audience is always different. Wherever you go, you'll get the audiences laugh at different things. So you're on your toes, really, with that one, because you think, oh, didn't get a laugh there, but you get a laugh somewhere else. So that keeps you on your toes. It's a good. We're all mates, so that's good. And backstage, we're all larking about, which we shouldn't do. We shouldn't say that. But we do, because I think that keeps everyone's spirits up. And I think if you're having a laugh and a joke as well, that keeps the energy up off stage. We're squirting, each other with water and God knows what else. Silly, childish things, but it makes us laugh. It's performing for audiences, and I think you always get the buzz. And also, different things happen. Things go wrong, as things did last night. Or people forget lines, or you never know what's going to happen. That's the lovely thing about live theatre. You don't know.
Do you prefer doing theatre, or would you rather do TV, where you can do it again if you make a mistake, or do you like the ad-libbing? What do you enjoy the most?
I love all aspects of acting. I think I'm very lucky to be acting at the moment, working, because there's so many of us. I think about 90% are out of work. I love television as well. When we filmed Hello, Hello, we had a live audience. So you still had to get your laughs. They weren't put on after. If you didn't get them, you didn't get them put on after. And I think that, but the performance comes down because you're larger on stage. And then when you're doing television, you have to bring your performance down. I remember when we were doing the Hello, Hello stage show, and we went from there to the telly, doing the telly, and David Croft turned around and he went, I was going, oh, René, hold me, kiss me, do all those things that drive me wild. And David went, Vicky, you're not on stage now. And you had to say, so you have to rethink. And you think, oh, sorry, David, yes, yeah, too big. Bring it down for television.
Because it amplifies everything they say,
yes.
Doesn't it?
Yeah, because you're so close on screen. You can see every movement of your face. And if you're over the top, you just look sort of, I don't know, stupid, I think would be the word.
Is it just luck getting cast in a role like that? Because you didn't know that it was still going to be as popular today as it was then when you took the role. Do you get a sense of how good a show is? David Croft obviously was a clue that it might be big. But, I mean, did you know at the time?
No one ever really knows. But when I read the script, you laughed. I mean, you read that pilot and you laughed. But it was funny because I read for two parts, Michelle of the Resistance and Yvette. And the reason that I went for Hello, Hello is because I'd been for a show called Come Back, Mrs. Noah that Jimmy Perry and David Croft had written. And my sister, it was out of my sister and myself who got that part.
Oh, really?
And my sister and Michelle got that part. He decided to go with Anne. But I played in that French-made robot.
Right.
And then after that, Jeremy Lloyd and David Croft got together and they wrote this Hello, Hello. And there was a part, French accent. So he rang up and said, Vicky, what's your French accent? I said, terrific, as you would. And I read for both parts, and then I got the part of Yvette. So the mums and dads, the grands and grandpas got the rude bits. And the children sort of didn't, but they knew there was something rude there. So they laughed just because their parents were laughing. But then you did have things like sausages and, kids aren't stupid, and bottoms and I think Arthur Bostrom, I was pissing by your coffee. The kids would laugh at that, but it was always covered. It was always covered by, well, he's only saying I was passing by your cafe. Everything was covered, but of course it was there was the nuances or the little rude bit. What, a fallen Madonna with the big boobies. Sort of boobies, the kids must have loved that, It was fantastic. I said, oh, David, why couldn't you have given that to me so that I could, I could speak that cod English. It was such a fantastic part. And Arthur played it brilliantly, very deadpan. But they use that in schools. When the teachers are teaching children French, they're saying, this is how you sound to the French, right? If you don't pronounce it properly, which right. is great. So we were sort of helping people learn as well.
What was your favourite line from the whole series?
There were too many in Hello, Hello. There was, I liked in Herr Flick's line in the pilot when he picked up the phone and he went, Hello, Flick, the Gestapo. No, I said flick the Gestapo. Well, leave it up to you. But that was very risque, but they really, but you know, but it was left in the mind. He never actually said a rude word, but it was left in people's minds. And for me, obviously, I asked David Croft if I could have my own line, like, listen very carefully, I shall say this only once, or you stupid one. He went, no, Vicky, we've got enough of those, you can't have fun on. All right, then. But every week I went, O-O-O-H, Rene. So in the beginning I go, oh, Rene, old me, oh, Rene. And then it's sort of, oh, Rene. And then it got long, and then he went, oh, Rene. And so I developed that, and that became my catchphrase, as it was, I suppose.
And the thing that everybody remembers and loves.
Yes, thank you. Murder on the throat.
I always think with things like hello, hello, it's a bit like around the horn. I don't think you'd get away with it today if somebody wrote it in a modern context, because there's so much in it that you can go, oh, flick, what do they mean by... Do you know what I mean?
Well, you do, but because no one's saying it, it's your mind, it's your imagination that's saying, see, it's not us.
I'm the deviant for thinking
it. You're the deviant for thinking. Absolutely right, and that is so. No one's going to admit, oh, that was terribly, terribly rude, because it's them and not us, and I think that was the secret. And obviously, the children knew, you know, so what, and the parents would laugh at what was implied that he was saying, but nothing was ever. There was never any. We never swore. You know, we embraced Rene and I, but we never actually kissed. You know, and it was all in people's minds. I mean, if you. Men come up and say, oh, those lovely short skirts you wore in Hello, Hello. Well, I didn't. I wore a knee-length skirt. But in their imaginations, I was the French maid with the short skirt. So it's those ideas, I think, that we put in. But that's British humour. And it worked. And we sold to about 80 countries, which is fantastic. I mean, that's worldwide, you know. You go abroad to some remote country and they know you.
In Guatemala, they come up and want an autograph.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely.
Well, I'd like to thank you because, I mean, you got me through puberty, so thank you so much.
Well, I'm so pleased with that, Ali. Oh, Ali.
There's a thought to leave you with to put you off this evening's show. Vicky Michelle.
Oh, thank you, Alison. Thank you for inviting me into your broom cupboard.
Well, no, but this is our glamorous studios. How dare you?
Oh.